In the next couple of minutes is just give you an overview of what the app looks like and just a walkthrough of a couple of the transactions or processes that can be carried out through the app. Now, as you're seeing over here, there is a default dashboard that's available, and this is also configurable. There are other specific widgets that can be configured and set up, but here's a typical one which shows when certificates are expiring over the next couple of weeks, and also for individuals, whether you're certificate requesters or approvers, a summary of what's available in your queue. Are there requests waiting to be approved for issuance, for installations, for renewals, and so on? Okay. So the key things that are the key processes that are supported through this integration app is, of course, to create a new request for a new certificate, or you can also process renewals through the app, and then also be able to revoke a certificate and then retire a certificate, or in other words, not monitor that certificate and keep track of it. And essentially, that's what a retire certificate is. So I just want to do a quick demo of how to request for a new certificate. And two things that you will notice over here is, one, when you request for a certificate, you're always identifying which is the business application that's consuming the certificate. So in my demo environment, I've doing this example where we have an HRIS business application. Ultimately, it's that application and its different system components that's consuming the certificate. And the certificate is always going to be mapped to that. Now, we identify this group called as an assignment group or a support group or an operational group, and, different companies will call it different names. But for us, this is the group of users that will be, the certificate custodian. And, they will be responsible for, identifying the need for the certificate, making sure that the, correct information is provided and know where it's going to be installed and so on. And then there is also an approval group that is more from a segregation of duties. When you have an ops group and they have to carry out certain tasks, there is a review and an approver. Finally, also a business owner for this certificate. Now, all of this information in terms of support group, approval group, business owner is automatically picked up from an organization's CMDB when they choose a specific business application, right? Similar to Venafi, you can also specify how this certificate should be managed, whether it is just the user make a request and Venafi issue the certificate, and that's what enrollment's about, or do we want to leverage the automation capabilities of Venafi and have Venafi deploy the certificate onto a Java Key Store or a Windows IIS server or an F5 virtual server and so on. Okay. Again, some other questions in terms of identifying what the certificate's for, and is it an internal, external server, and then also identify what kind of a certificate is requested for, because the template. Information about the certificate so it can be managed effectively on an ongoing basis. So I'm just going to go ahead and just create a cert, and this is information that you typically used to handling when you create a certificate request, and that's to provide the name, the OU, the organization, the city, state. Now, in one of the previous slides, we did look at how PKI administrators can implement certain policies on the Venafi system, and we've replicated the whole thing over here by adding making use of organization values and making use of other properties such as location, and all of this comes from the CMDB. The other main feature of this integration app is that it links with your server CMDB, and you can identify servers from your list of currently configured servers, and when a server is selected, the IP addressing associated with that, the location, all of that information is automatically taken and then used for creating the objects in Venafi. And of course, you can also identify what kind of a key store should be, will be used to deploy the certificate to, and this is very similar to what we see in Venafi, right? Other properties you have in terms of key size, encryption algorithm, again, these are all things that we would configure on the basis of a company-wide policy, and we don't have to have the users, you know, worry about those things and have to enter them. And the process that typically happens is the certificate requester would submit this request, and then the request would be automatically sent to whoever specified as part of the approval group, and members of the approval group will then approve the request, assuming that everything is correct. And then the app will then connect to Venafi and create the required policy folders, create the device, the application objects, and submit it for enrollment. Okay. The same capability is also available when you want to create a certificate, but this time, because of a special circumstance, you want to upload a CSR. The key pair is not going to be created on Venafi. So requesting a certificate using a CSR is also supported. So all you need to do is indicate that yes, there's a CSR that's going to be submitted, and you have the CSR available, and upload the CSR, and then provide the other information. Right, and then the rest of the process is to identify which device it's going to go on, what kind of key store it's going to go on, provide the information, and then submit. So that's a field order, right? So requesting certificates through CSRs is also submitted. Now, once that entire request is submitted and all of the the integration activities happen, the user will get a notification that the certificate is available for download, and typically we'll have this download certificate option available. And when you do the download certificate, optimally, and even a number of types of formats are supported, and then the certificate is retrieved from Venafi TPP. Now, again, it's important to note that while in carrying out this activity, there's no information cached anywhere. So there's a copy of the certificate and key is not going to be brought over to ServiceNow and stored there. All of this is within the same session, and there's no private key that's stored anywhere within ServiceNow, right? And so you see over here that I'm able to download the certificate, and then from a process perspective, the user just needs to check this checkbox to confirm that they have installed the certificate, and then save the request, and that will complete the request. And you also notice that once the request is completed, that download certificate option is gone. So it's not that a user can come and look up any ServiceNow request and be able to download certificates and private keys, right? This is available only at the time of, the request being in the state of certificate issue. Okay. Other request types that are supported is provisioning type of request. So I've already created a request over here for a certificate, where I provided the certificate details, provided the SAN information, and in this case, I've identified that this is the server that it needs to go on, and this needs to be a Java key store, and all the information required for Venafi to successfully create and configure that Java key store has also been provided over here. Okay, and then when you submit that, it will then go and trigger the workflows within Venafi, and then have that installed. Okay, so this is a request that's in a stage where the certificate has been issued, but now it's pending installation approval. One of the approvers will then go and approve this certificate for installation, and then the system will then connect to Venafi and approve the Stage 800 workflow, for those of you who are familiar with Venafi, and then proceed to install the certificate. Another of a provisioning type of a request, but this time, it is for a Windows IIS server. Okay. In addition to that, the other types of requests that are supported is, we call it a revoke request. So when a certificate needs to be revoked, you can select it from the list all of the information about that certificate, will be populated, and you specify the reason as to why you want to revoke that, and then submit the request. And this will also go through its approval cycle. And someone from the certificate approvers group is going to approve the revocation, and then it gets revoked on ServiceNow. And then we also have the retire, so it's possible to retire or stop processing a certificate going forward. Again, select the certificate and provide the reason, and then submit that. Okay. The other point that I quickly make to kind of conclude my demo is renewals are also handled, and the way renewals are handled is that Venafi TPP will identify a certificate that needs to be renewed, and and you will have a request created in this queue. The request will be of a type of certificate renewal request, so associated approval group or the custodian group can then look at the certificate, validate all of its properties, and then submit that for renewal. Okay, so that's a quick overview of all of the major processes that are supported within the app.
That's great, thank you, Jeffrey. It looks like pretty much everything that a certificate owner would need to do: request certificates, install, renew, revoke, or retire. All available to them within ServiceNow. And I know you went through that fairly quickly to show us a lot of stuff, but it did look pretty straightforward as far as clicking, using dropdowns, sort of helping